Welcome back everybody, this is my third video for my AI project for StarCraft 2. In this video I'm going to show you the map analysis techniques I have programmed in the last couple of days. I've added four computer AIs in this on this map. They are Protoss, so they won't do anything except mine the minerals, so you can ignore those. This is all about the base locations and the choke points of those locations. As you can see on the left, I've left some debug messages on so you can see what's going on. It says here that it has located 16 base locations. And if you look on the map, it's Delta Quadrant. There are 16 locations. The back door, natural, the front door, natural, the main, and a gold expansion for every player. Now, the detection of chokes. If you've seen the first video, you could remember all those colored beacons at the edge of a base, which would detect or look for ramps which can be chokes in this case. Now, I've created some triggers to respond on chat commands, so I can activate the choke searching algorithm through a chat command. So if I want to look for chokes in the first base, there we go. Let's analyze the log. It first starts with checking the northeast edge, and it has found a narrow ramp, which is the narrow ramp up here. Then it starts checking the northwest edge, which it also found a narrow ramp. The southwest and the southeast edge didn't find anything. It says here that the edge is 1, which means it is closed. It has found it has closed the edge from the beacon on the right. It has found the beacon on the top from east to north, because it is possible if there is not a ramp but a small choke, those two while tracking the cliff line, you will not it will not encounter the beacon on the top. If that happens, the beacon at the top will start tracking the cliff line as well to start looking for the beacon on in the east, and it will remember the closest position it got to make sure that is the choke. I'll show you later. It makes it a lot more clear. If I do again test 1, you can see for the two chokes that are found. I use force fields to visualize points. Base 1 has 10 resource patches and base 1 has 2 chokes. Now the 10 resource patches are the 8 minerals and the 2 geysers. If I go for base 2, that's the back door entrance here. Also all for once, because it's entirely closed, and it found 1 narrow ramp choke. Also 10 resource patches. Now the interesting stuff happens at this base. This is base number 3. Because there is a choke here, there's a choke here, there's a choke here, and there's a choke here. But this is not a ramp. But it still can detect this. Let's go. There we go. Check the log. It found a wide ramp choke and another one. Those are the two big ones here. It found a wide choke, so no ramp. And it found a narrow ramp choke, which is the entrance to the main here. And you can see the northeast edge is 2, which means it found a choke, but it's not closed. The other three edges are closed. So when the beacon on the east wants to reach the beacon on the north, it starts tracking the edge and it doesn't find it. after a couple of tries and a maximum distance, it stops trying. And then the beacon on the north, which is somewhere here, it starts tracking the cliff to see if it can reach east. And it also starts tracking the cliff line and also does not find it. While he is tracking the cliff line, he is constantly searching in area in circles around these beacons while he places them for these beacons. That's why this is Protoss beacon, this is Terran beacon. And when it got to this beacon, it found this one and stores this distance. And while he's tracing, every beacon in this range probably found one of these beacons, but this is the one he stored, these two, because this is the closest position. Now, if I ask him to show me the choke points, there you go. It has 4 chokes. This is the choke he stored on the wide ramps and also in the main. And again, the 10 research patches. So it has the it is capable of detecting a choke which is not a ramp. Now, if you go to base 4, well, it's the high yield here, which is completely closed again, all 1s and 2 main ramps. So nothing special about that. The interesting part starts with you noticed when I was tracking the chokes for this one, the beacons tracking the cliff lines, it stopped here because the distance between this beacon and the base location where it started from was getting too large. If those beacons would have found this ramp again, it would have noted this ramp as another choke point. But this choke point is not kind of needless for this base, because it's much too far and you have to pass through another choke point, say this one, to get here anyway. So I had to build in a check to make sure that those kind of chokes are removed later on. And I can show you that with this base up here. This is base number 14. As you can see, it found a narrow ramp choke in the northwest edge, which is the entrance to the main base. And there are 4 wide ramp chokes found, which is this one, this one, this one, and this one, which includes 2 of the ramps, which are not really chokes at all, at least not for this base. So those ones should be removed. So if I ask him again to show me those chokes he found, force fields here, 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 those 3 are correct. Also the one at the top, but there are a force field here and a force field here. I do not want those chokes. Now, I have programmed, or the only way for me to know that this choke is a needless one, is one that is not required to be stored for this base, is if you want to move from this base to this choke, and if you encounter another choke in the process, this one or this one, then this choke is needless. So that's exactly what I did. The toolkit lacks an option for me to check if a certain point is within a certain path, so I have to do that manually by spawning units at the base location and order them to move to all those chokes and keep checking them if they encounter another choke which is not their destination. Let me show you spawn 14. There you go. This one goes for the main ramp, and I have a log file. The walker reached designated choke, keeping it. So there was the guy who was walking up to the main ramp. He reached the choke he was trying to reach, so that choke is valid. 2 guys moved to the left here. 1 guy was for this choke, and another guy was for this joke. One guy, of the guy for this joke, reached this joke, so we keep this. This one is valid. But the guy that was going for this joke crossed this joke first. So that's why the walker passed another joke, removing destination. So this joke is now removed from the database. And the same for this one. As you can see here in the log that he removed two jokes from the database. If I ask him again to show me the jokes for base 14, the jokes are gone and I only have the four jokes remaining, which it should have. So that's the power of this algorithm on this map. So as you can see on this map, it can detect all the jokes for all the different bases. I will show you one more one other map. Blistering Sands is a good one, which has a lot of open bases, which has a lot of jokes, and let's see if he can recognize those directly. Let me load up Blistering Sands now. And there we go, Blistering Sands. It has found 8 bases on this map, which you can see there are 8 bases. Now, for the first base, nothing special. It's a closed base with 2 ramps, and you can see here it's found a destructible ramp joke, which is the back door, the famous back door. Base 2 is going to be the natural. It found the wide ramp joke, which is this one, which is not really a choke point for this base. And to prove that to him, we can spawn the walkers again. He reached this choke, and the walker that was going for this choke passed this choke, so that one is removed. So we can see it only has 2 chokes. But the real interesting bases are this one and this one, because they have a lot of open space and a lot of chokes around them. So let's see what happens. There we go. Wide ramp choke 1, wide ramp choke 2, a wide choke, a narrow ramp choke, a wide ramp choke, destructible ramp choke, a narrow choke, and a wide ramp choke. That's a lot of chokes, and I'm almost certain almost half of those are needless. So let's see which chokes they are. So from the minimap pings, you can see where they are located. This choke over here, a choke there, the ramp, and a ramp here. A small choke here, this ramp, and this ramp. So a lot of needless chokes. So let's see what the walkers make of them. And there they go. Yep, oh, and removing 4 out of 8 chokes. So let's see again what happens. Give me the chokes. Yeah, here we go. Choke point on this ramp, narrow choke here, narrow choke here, and a choke on this ramp. Although this is not exactly a choke point out of that needs to be defended, because this is a dead end technically. But the AI that will control the army will have calculations per choke point to make sure it doesn't gather all its forces up here. But there you go. This is my code for detecting chokes. You can see it's pretty flexible. I haven't found a map where it doesn't work yet. So this should be extremely helpful in letting the AI control its army properly. Okay, and thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you next time.